हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम अगेन फॉर दिस गणित प्रावीण्य लेक्चर. इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर एक्सरसाइज 7. ओके, इन बिफोर वीडियो वी हैव सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 7 टिल 28. ओके, सो नाउ इन दिस पार्ट वी विल सॉल्व रिमेनिंग क्वेश्चंस इन द एक्सरसाइज 7. सी, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस वीडियो I recommend you to open your Xerox pages, refer the questions, instructions of questions in the Xerox pages, because I'm not going to write here directly. We are going to solve answers here. Okay, see your question number 29. There is instructions for question number 29 to 33. See, you have to put your finger so that you will understand the instructions. Okay, recollect the meaning of the equivalent fractions and the way to obtain them. Write down the numbers in the boxes in order in question number 29 to 33. If there are boxes in the both numerator and denominator, write the number in the place of numerator and the denominator. Okay. So here, this question number 29 to 33, here I have written till 32. Question number 29 to question number 33 are based on the concept of equivalent fraction. And we have learned the equivalent fraction already in our regular maths, okay? So you know that equivalent fractions can be, means equivalent fractions means what, the fractions which look different but their values are same. And we have learned to obtain the equivalent fraction, to find the equivalent fraction by two ways, multiplication, by using multiplication and by using division. Okay, so that was the concept of equivalent fraction which we have learned already, and these questions are based on it. See, 4 upon 9 is equal to 4 multiply by 2 upon dash multiply by 2 is equal to dash upon dash, or box upon box. Okay, so we have to put the proper values, proper numbers in the boxes. Understood? It's very easy question. See here, you know that when any fraction is given 1 by 7 and we have to find its equivalent fraction, we multiply both, multiply or divide both numerator and denominator by same number. If we multiply numerator by 2, that means we have to multiply denominator also by 2, so that we will get its equivalent fraction. 2 ones are 2, 2 sevens are 14. So 2 upon 14 is equivalent fraction of 1 upon 7. So if you are multiplying, then we have to multiply both numerator and denominator by same number. If we are dividing, see, suppose there is 48 divide by 36, then if you are dividing 48 by 6, then we need to divide 36 also by 6, so that we will get 6 8s are 48 and 6 6s are 36, 8 upon 6. So 48 upon 36 is same as 8 upon 6. Okay, 8 upon 6 is equivalent fraction of 48 upon 36. Okay, so these are two ways of finding equivalent fraction which we have learned already. Understood? So here also these questions are based on this concept, equivalent fraction. 4 upon 9 is equal to 4 into 2. Here they have used multiplication. 4 multiply by 2 upon dash multiply by 2. What number will come in this box? What? Yes, this denominator, 9. Okay. Now 4 twos are what? 8. What is 4 twos are? 8. Whereas 9 twos are 18. So 8 upon 18 is the equivalent fraction for this 4 upon 9 when both numerator and denominators are multiplied by 2. Okay. Next. Question number 30. 4 upon 9 is equal to 9 into dash. See here they have done mistake, printing mistake. This 4 write up, 9 write down. Okay. Now see, 4 upon 9 is equal to 4 into box upon 9 into 3. So since denominator is multiplied by 3, that means numerator should be multiplied by 3 only. So here 4 multiplied by 3. Now 4 threes are what? 12. And what is 9 threes are? 27. So 12 upon 27 is the equivalent fraction according to this multiplication by 3. Question number 31. 13 upon 8 is equal to dash upon 40. See, this is given fraction 13 upon 8 and its equivalent fraction, in this equivalent fraction of 13 upon 8, denominator is 40. Then what will be its numerator? Okay, so this example we have solved. What we have to do? In the given fraction, denominator is 8 and its equivalent fraction, denominator is 40. Then think that to get 40, by which number we must multiply 8? 8 into 5. 8 5s are 40. Okay? And since we have multiplied denominator by 5, that means what, you know? We have to multiply numerator also by 5. Okay? Then only we will get its equivalent fraction. So 8 5s are 40. Then what is 13 5s are? 13 5s are 65. Okay, 13 5s are 65. So 65 is the number which will come in this box. Similarly, question number 32. 8 upon 9 is equal to dash upon 72. Now here in the given fraction, denominator is 9, whereas in the equivalent fraction, denominator is 72. Okay. So now think that by which number we should multiply 9 so that we will get 72. 9 8s are 72, correct? And since we have multiplied denominator by 8, that means we need to multiply numerator also by 8. So 9 8s are 72 and 8 8s are 64. Okay, so 64 upon 72 is the equivalent fraction of 8 upon 9. Understood? In this question number 33, you have to solve practice by yourself, which is based on same concept. Okay, let's see question number 33. Question number 34. Question number 34. Pay attention, you have to put your finger. I'm reading here. Write down an equivalent fraction. Write down an equivalent fraction to 3 upon 4. Write down an equivalent fraction to 3 upon 4 having the numerator 15. Numerator 15. Understood this question? We have to find such equivalent fraction of 3 upon 4 whose numerator is 15. Then what must be its denominator? Just that only we have to find. Okay, so now numerator is 15 and here in the given fraction numerator is 3. By which number when we will multiply 3 so that we will get 15? 3 5s are 15. And since we have multiplied numerator by 5, we must multiply denominator also by 5. So 4 5s are 20. Understood? So 15 upon 20 is the equivalent fraction of 3 upon 4 having numerator 15. That's it. The next question, question number 35. See, write down an equivalent fraction to 5 upon 4. Write down an equivalent fraction to 5 upon 4 whose or having the numerator 28. Means what? In the equivalent fraction of 5 upon 4, the numerator is 20. The numerator is 28. So here see, there is one printing mistake. Instead of the numerator, write down the equivalent fraction to 5 upon 4 having the numerator. So instead of this numerator, cut that numerator and write the denominator. Okay, so having denominator 28, then what will be its न्यूमरेटर. फाइंड द इक्विवेलेंट फ्रैक्शन ऑफ 5 अपॉन 4 हैविंग डिनोमिनेटर 28. देन ओके सो देन व्हाट विल बी इट्स न्यूमरेटर दैट वी हैव टू फाइंड. सो सी हियर इन द गिवन फ्रैक्शन डिनोमिनेटर इज 4 एंड इन द इक्विवेलेंट फ्रैक्शन डिनोमिनेटर इज 28. ओके सो टू गेट 28 बाय विच नंबर वी शुड मल्टीप्लाई 4. 4 sevens are 28. 4 sevens are 28. Then what is 5 sevens are? Since we have multiplied denominator by 7, that means we must multiply numerator also by same number 7. Okay. So 4 sevens are 28 and 5 sevens are 35. Understood? Next. Question number 36. Question number 36. Put your finger on the question. Which fraction is equivalent to 2 upon 3? That means 2 upon 3 is given fraction. And which fraction is equivalent to 2 upon 3 having 17 times the numerator and denominator? Means what? We have to find such equivalent fraction of 2 upon 3 having 17 times the both numerator and denominator. Now 17 times means what, you know? 17 times means multiply by 17 to both numerator and denominator. Understood? 17 times of both numerator and denominator means what? 17 by 17 we have to multiply both numerator and denominator, then the fraction which we'll obtain, that is the equivalent fraction, which is 17 times of both numerator and denominator. So what we have to do here, we have to multiply both numerator and denominator by 17. When we say 17 times of 2, that means what? Meaning of this times, 17 times of 2 means what? 17 multiplied by 2. Okay? So 17 times of numerator and denominator means what? 17 multiplied by numerator and 17 multiplied by denominator. So after multiplying both numerator and denominator by 17, the fraction which we will get, that is the equivalent fraction according to this condition. So what is 17 2s are? 34. And 17 3s are? 51. Understood? We'll make box to this both of this numerator and denominator. 34 upon 51 is the equivalent fraction of 2 upon 3 when both numerator and denominators are multiplied by 17. Understood? Next, question number 37. If the numerator of a fraction equivalent to 5 upon 8 is 25. See, get the meaning of the language of the question. What is that? If the numerator of fraction equivalent to 5 upon 8 means there is fraction 5 upon 8 and it's in its equivalent fraction the numerator is 25. Understood meaning? If the numerator of a fraction equivalent to 5 upon 8 is 25, what is its denominator? Then what will be its denominator? Understood question? So it's, once you understand the meaning of question, then to find answer is very easy. You know that how to find. Just you have to write in correct way. Okay, you have to mention the data in correct way. 5 upon 8. The question says, if the numerator of a fraction equivalent to 5 upon 8 is 25, numerator is 25 in the equivalent fraction of 5 upon 8, then what is its denominator? Okay, so you know 5 into 5, 5 5s are 25, that and 8 5s are what? 40. Understood. Next. क्वेश्चन नंबर 38, ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 38. Why cannot be the denominator of a fraction equivalent to 9 upon 14 is 24? Why cannot be the denominator of the fraction? Why cannot be the denominator of a fraction equivalent to 9 upon 14 is 24? What is meaning of this? This 24 cannot be denominator of equivalent fraction of 9 upon 14. Why? Because, see, this is not equal. Why? Because in table of 14 there is no 24. If is there any number by which when we will multiply 14 so that we will get 24? No. So in the equivalent fraction of 9 upon 14, 24 cannot be denominator because 24 is not multiple of 14. Multiple means not in table of 14. Right? You know how we find the numerator or denominator in the equivalent fraction? We multiply by the same number. So since here 20, if we cannot multiply 14 by any number so that we will get 24. Right? That's why 24 cannot be the denominator in the equivalent fraction of 9 upon 14. Here, then there should be such number which is in table of 14. Then only it will be the equivalent fraction for this 9 upon 14. Okay? That's it. Next, question number 39. Question number 39 is here. What is the denominator of a fraction having numerator 7 equivalent to 63 upon 18? What is the denominator of a fraction having numerator 7 and equivalent to 63 upon 18? Means given fraction is 63 upon 18 and in its equivalent fraction the numerator is 7, then what will be its denominator? See now, question. Once again, see question. What is the denominator of a fraction? What is the denominator of a fraction having numerator 7 and equivalent to 63 upon 18? Okay? Then what will be its denominator? Once we have written here data carefully, correctly, then we will solve it. 63 upon 18 is equal to 7 upon 6 dash, means they are equivalent. Now here, to find this denominator, what we have to do? As I told you, whether we can multiply both numerator and denominator by same number, or another way is we can divide the numerator and denominator by same number. Now here, if you will observe this 63 upon 18 and here 7 upon something, okay, so here this numerator and this numerator, if you observe, in equivalent fraction the numerator is smaller than the numerator in the given fraction. That means what? Here we must divide this numerator and denominator, because here this fraction is what? It is smaller in number, not in value. I am saying it is smaller in numbers. That means what? Here must be divided to 63. You know, 63 divided by dash, or by which number we must divide 63 so that we will get 7 as a quotient. You know, 9 sevens are 63, you know that 9 sevens are 63. That means to get 7 we must divide 63 by 9. So 63 divided by 9, and since we have divided 63 by 9, so we must divide denominator also by 9. That is 9 7s are 63 and 9 2s are 18. 9 2s are 18, okay? So the expected fraction is 7 upon 2, or the denominator in the equivalent fraction of 63 upon 18 is 2. Understood? pause this video for some time and write this in your, this you can write in the textbook also, okay? Write this in the textbook only, means that Xerox only. Now see, we will solve next questions. See a question number 40. Write down the fraction having numerator 48 and denominator 80 in its most reduced form. See here, question number 40. Fraction, given fraction is, numerator is 48 and denominator is 80. This is given fraction, and this fraction we have to write in its most reduced form. This is new word for you, most reduced form. What is meaning of this? I'll tell you first. The meaning of word reduce means to reduce, means to make less. To make less. Most reduced means smallest, the smallest. Means what? This is the fraction 48 upon 80. We have to write its such equivalent fraction which is most smallest, or the smallest, sorry. The smallest, most reduced. Okay? So, what we have to do here? We have to divide for numerator and denominator. When we have to write reduced form of any fraction, most reduced form of any fraction, at that time we have to divide both numerator and denominator by their highest common factor, HCF. Okay, so HCF of 48 and 80, what is that? Can you tell me highest common factor of 48 and 80? Can you guess? Can you tell me orally such number in which table both 48 and 80 is there? Both 48 and 80 is there in that number, and it must be highest. Okay, because 48 and 80 is there in table of 8 also. After that, 48 and 80 are there in table of 16 also. 16 threes are 48 and 16 fives are 80. Is there any other number than 16 which is in which table there is 48 and 80, or by which 48 and 80 is divisible? No. The 16 is only the highest common factor of 48 and 16. Okay? So to find the most reduced form of 48 and 80, or smallest form, we must divide 48 and 80 by its HCF, that is 16. So let's do it. 48 upon 80. So divide by 16. Divide by 16. 16 threes are 48. Okay. And 16 fives are 80. 48 divided by 16, 3. And 80 divided by 16, 5. So 3 upon 5 is the most reduced form of 48 upon 80. There is smallest form. There is not other form, of 48 and 80 which is smaller than this. This is the smallest one, okay? So whenever you have to find reduced form or smallest form of any fraction, you have to divide both numerator and denominator by their HCF, okay? This HCF you can find by prime factorization method also, if you are not able to write here directly. But try to guess directly. This will help you to solve the example quickly. How to do that? See, think that 48 and 80 are divisible by which highest number? You can think, you know the tables, then you can think easily, okay? So try in that way. This is the answer, 3 upon 5. You can write down this in your notebook. Then question number 41. This is very interesting question and important. See here. Put your finger when I'm reading. How many times should 1 by 8 be added to 1 by 8 so that the sum will be 1? Means in the 1 by 8, how many times again 1 by 8 we must add? How many times 1 by 8 again to be added in this 1 by 8 so that their sum, their addition will be 1. Okay, so here see, we have not learned addition of fraction. We have another option to find the solution of this question. What you know, see, if you observe this fraction 1 by 8, this is numerator, this is denominator, and you know the denominator indicates what? Total equal parts, and numerator indicates shaded part. Okay, so see here, this is suppose chocolate, and this is one whole chocolate, this is one chocolate, okay, one chocolate. And now this here denominator is, that means what, this is, this chocolate is suppose divided into 8 equal parts. And 1 by 8 means out of 8 equal parts, 1 is shaded. So this one shaded part indicates 1 by 8. Okay. What is the question? In this 1 by 8, how many times again 1 by 8 we must add so that we will get 1 whole? 1 whole. Means that means what? To get this 1 whole chocolate, again how many 1 by 8 we need to add in this? See, this is one 1 by 8. Then again, suppose if we talk about this one part, this is 1 by 8. This is, then this is 1 by 8. This one part is represent 1 by 8. The likewise, all each one part indicates 1 by 8, right? Each part of the chocolate, see, this was one whole chocolate, we divided one whole chocolate into 8 equal parts, and each part, if we shade, it indicates 1 by 8. This is 1 by 8, this is 1 by 8, this is 1 by 8, 1 out of 8, okay? So now see, how many 1 by 8 makes one whole? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 times 1 by 8 makes one whole. 8 times 1 by 8 makes one whole chocolate. Understood? Now this 1 by 8 means this is given 1 by 8, okay? In this, how many times again 1 by 8 when we will add so that we will get one whole chocolate? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Again 7 times 1 by 8 we have to add. 7 times 1 by 8 we have to add in this given so that we will get one whole chocolate. Are you getting me? See, there was one whole chocolate, it is divided into 8 equal parts, and each one part indicates 1 by 8. Each one part represent 1 by 8, 1/8 fraction, 1/8 of the chocolate. So such, to get whole chocolate, how many more 1/8 should be added in that? How many? Remaining 7 1/8 we need to add in this given 1 by 8. Okay. So, what is the question? 7 times 1 by 8 need to be added in 1 by 8 to get 1. Okay? In this 1 by 8, again 7 times 1 by 8 when you will add, at that time you will get 1. As we have taken here, example of one chocolate. One whole chocolate was there, we divided into 8 equal parts, each part indicates 1 by 8. Okay, that so this 1 by 8 means this given 1 by 8, if you will consider. Then to get this whole chocolate, to make this one whole chocolate, Again, how many times 1 by 8 are there? 7 times 1 by 8 are there, that we need to add in this. Okay, so 7 times 1 by 8 need to be added in 1 by 8 to get 1. Understood? Okay. I think this type of example we have solved in our regular maths also. Okay. Next. Pause this video and write this in your notebook. Then we will solve next examples. See, question number 42. This is also very interesting example and related to our daily life. If you know the concept of fraction, these examples are very easy. Try to get the concept of fraction, okay? See, question number 42, I'm reading. Pay attention carefully, put your finger. A can of milk contains milk to 1/3 the height of the can. 1/3 the height of the can. If the milk is 5 liter, what is the capacity of the can when it is full? See here, there is one can of milk. Okay, suppose this is can of milk. Okay. This can of milk contains the milk to 1/3 to the height, 1/3 the height of the can. So this is total height from here to here. This is total height of the can. 1/3 means what? What is meaning of this 1/3? 1/3 height of the can means what? 1/3 height of the can means what? This can, total height of the can is divided into 3 equal parts. Total height of the can is divided into 3 equal parts. And one out of 3 equal parts, it contains 1/3 height, means one part, this much milk. One part, if when this can is divided into 3 equal parts, okay, so currently a can of milk contains milk to 1/3 of the height of the can. 1/3 the height of the can. Understood? Means it is divided into 3 parts. And in one, out of 3 parts, in one part there is milk. Okay. If the milk is 5 liter. Now this milk is till one part. Okay. And this milk means what? 5 liter. One part of the milk means 5 liter. That means total how many milk this can contain? Or total how many, what is the capacity of this can? When it is full, means if the can is full of milk, how much milk it can hold? Can you guess? One, out of 3 parts, one part means 5 liter milk. Then this one part means 5 liter and this one part means 5 liter. Total, how many milk will be there in the can when it is full? Total 15 liter, right? By this figure, you might have understood. Okay, so see here, how to solve this example? Out of 3 parts, 3 equal parts, one part of milk, one part of can is equal to how much milk? 5 liter milk. 5 liter milk, okay? Then such total, how many parts are there? 1, 2 and 3. So, 3 parts of can is equal to how many liter milk will be there? 5 threes are 15 liter. So, this can, capacity of can is 15 liter. Can hold 15 liter of milk. So, the capacity of can is 15 liter. Okay? 15 liter. Once again, I explain this here. There is one can of milk. currently there is one third of the milk, one third of milk. Whenever it is said that one third height of the can contains milk, okay, one third means what? Three indicates equal parts, total equal parts. So that means can is divided into three equal parts. Out of three, one is given. That means it contains milk till one part. Okay, so one part means they have given. If the milk is 5 liter, means one part means 5 liter milk. Then what is capacity of can when it is full? If milk is still this, means three parts. Okay, then what is total milk it can hold? So one part means 5 liter. So three parts means 5 threes are 15 liter. Understood? Yes. You can pause this video and write this example, solution of this example in your notebook. Okay. Then question number 43. See question number 43. Pay attention carefully. They have given one figure. Circle they have given. Okay. Now see, initially if you observe, this circle is divided into four equal parts, 1, 2, 3, and 4. But again this part, again it is divided into three parts, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, what we have to write? How much part of the circle in the adjoining figure is shaded? How much part of the circle is in the adjoining figure is shaded? How much part they are asking, not how many part. How many parts means you will count the parts, but how much part of circle means you have to write in the form of fraction. Understood? So see here, if you'll talk about the, this big part here, this whole big part is not shaded, large part is not shaded. This this part is again divided into three equal parts. So similarly this also part we will divide into three parts. Okay, each part will divide into three parts so that all parts will be equal. This one whole part and these two parts, like three parts, will not consider because they were not equal. So what we have done, we divided this whole circle into equal parts, and since this 1/4 was divided into again three parts, so each 1/4 we divided into three parts. Now all parts are equal. So total how many parts are there now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So total equal parts means they should be written in the denominator, 12. Now out of 12 equal parts, how many are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Out of 12, 5 are shaded. So how much part of circle is shaded? 5 twelfth part of the circle is shaded. Okay, next question number 44. See this. If 2/3 part of a number be 60, what is that number? 2/3 part of a number be 60. Now see here also, this also example is same like this. 2/3 part, here also I will draw one figure so that you will able to understand easily. This is suppose chocolate. The given fraction is 2/3, and the, you know that when any fraction is given, the denominator in that fraction indicates total equal parts. Okay, so suppose this chocolate is divided into three parts as there is denominator 3, and out of 3 numerator is 2, that means two parts are shaded. Okay, now 2/3 or 2/3 part of a number, this is one whole number. Suppose the two-third part of a number be 60. So these two parts means what? 60. Two parts means 60. Then what is this whole number means? Okay, now two parts is equal to 60. Then can you tell me one part means how much? Then one part means how much? 2, these two parts are equal. Okay, so that means 60 should this two parts, two equal parts indicates represent 60. Then each one part should be divided equally. Okay, each one means 60 should be divided equally among these two parts. That means two parts means 60. So one part is equal to 60 divided by 2, that is 30. So each part indicates 30 30, you know, 30 plus 30 60. So as this one part means 60, this one part means 30, this one part means 30, so this one part also represent 30. So that means this total number is, so three parts is equal to what? One part means 30, so three parts means 30 into 3, that is 90. 30 plus 30 plus 30 90. Okay, that is your three parts means 33 is a 90. So we can say that two-third part of a number is 60. So the expected number is 90. Understood? Next, question number 45. There are other methods also to find the answer of this, but for that we must know the multiplication and division of the fraction, which we have not learned. Okay, directly they have given these questions. They have given multiplication and division afterwards. So we have to use this method. I will show you another, that method also. Two-third, it is like this. Two-third part of a number. Two-third part of a number. Two-third part of a number is equal to 60. Then what is that a number? So this will be written in this way. Two-third of means multiplication. A number means you can consider x is equal to 60. Then using transpose rule, this 3 which is in the denominator, it will come here, and 2 is in the numerator, it will go down. That is rule of the multiplication and division of the fraction. Okay, so 3 was in the denominator. When it changed the side, here there is equal sign. When it changed the side, it came in the numerator, and this 2 was in the numerator, it went down. Okay, so 2 ones are 2, 60 divided by 2, answer is 30, and 33 is a x is equal to 90. This is also another method, but you don't go by this method, go by this method so that you will understand concept also. This method we'll learn later. Okay, next, question number 45. See here, of what number is 4 upon 5 of 80 4 times as much? 4 upon 5 of 80. 4 upon 5 of 80. 4 upon 5 of 80 means what, you know? If the whole number is 80, if suppose we will take this example of chocolate, it is divided into 5 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. It is divided into 5 equal parts. This one whole chocolate indicates 80. One whole chocolate indicates 80. And it is divided into 5 equal parts, and out of 5 equal parts, 4 parts are shaded. Okay, that is 4/5. Okay, then what they are asking, of what number is 4 upon 5 of 80 4 times as much? So first you have to find 4/5 of 80. What is, how much or how many, what is 4/5 of 80? That we have to find first. 4/5 of 80 means 4 upon 5 of 80 means how much or how many? That we have to find first. Okay. Now see this 80, this one whole chocolate means 80. It is divided into 5 equal parts. So when 80 is divided into 5 equal parts, 80 divided by 5, what answer you will get? 16, right? 80 divided by 5 is what? 16. That means each part indicates 16, 16, 16, 16, 16. 16 5 is 80. Okay? So, here we can say that one part is equal to 16. Then 4 parts is equal to what? 4 parts is equal to 16 fours are. That is 16 plus 16 plus 16 plus 16. That is 16 fours are 64. So 4/5 of 80 is? 4/5 of 80 is 64. But this is not our answer. What we have to find? What number is? What number is 4/5 of 80? 4 times as much, okay? Means this 4/5 of 80 is 64. So this 64 is 4 times of which number? 64 is 4 times of which number? That means to which number? 4 times means what? Times means multiplication. As I told you in the previous question, times means multiplication. So 4 times of which number? That means which number multiply by 4? Then you will get 64. This 64. Okay? So this, to find this number, what we have to do? Can you tell me, if you know the table, 4 times of which number get 64? For that, either you can divide 64 by 4, then also you will get this number, or directly you can say table 16 for the 64. 16 for the 64. So this 64 is 4 times of which number? 16. 16. So the answer is 16. Understood? Answer is 16. I think you cannot see here. Okay, 16 for the, okay, the 64 is 4 times of 16. 16 for the 64. Understood? Once again I repeat this question. See, of what number is 4/5 of 80 4 times as much? Means what? 4/5 of 80 means 64. If 80 is divided into 5 equal parts, out of 5 equal parts, 4 parts means 64, and 64 is 4 times of which number? 16. 16 for the 64. So the answer is 16. Understood? Watch this again and again so that you can understand. See this figurical representation also, okay, to clear the concept. Here our exercise 7 is completed. If you have any doubt in this, you can ask. So thank you for today and have a nice day.